the most famous and most beautiful melodies in Arab music. But the Jews in Jerusalem, around 100 years ago, that came from Syria, from Aleppo, changed it and put Hebrew words in it. So in our version, we try to combine the two languages and the two traditions.
The next song is called Adon, Haselichot. It's a famous tune that is sang by the crowd in the synagogue in Yom Kippur. I remember this song from those days, Yom Kippur, when I went to the Knesset, to synagogue with my Iraqi and Kurdish grandfather. And I remember the impact. It was really, really powerful, even too powerful for me, this tune. It's amazing. So many years later, I decided to bring it to my place, not the crowd place, but really to our intimate, unique prayer, as all of us is a unique individual in this world. So I hope you connect.
Oh,
Thank you so much. And this next one is a very dear piece to me. It's called Jako. It's a Sephardic song, a Ladino song, sung in the Sephardic or Ladino language, which is the language of the Jews that maintained it after many years after they were expelled from Spain. And this song is from Thessaloniki, from Greece, but sung in Ladino, which is very similar to Spanish. And actually, Tamar taught me this song around a year ago. It was very easily connected to Flamenco, which is the music that I studied for many years in South of Spain. Really kind of got inside of me, got inside of my heart, and came out quite naturally with the Flamenco sound. So this is our...
Thank you. The last song we're going to play is called Matovu Tzevia. It's very dear to my heart. It comes from the tradition that I learned and that I come from. It comes from the Moroccan, Andalusian Moroccan tradition. And it's a song that's sang usually to the bride and admires the bride. So I always feel very festive when I sing it. And we start with istikhbar, which is the Latin word from the Andalusian tradition, also sang for the bride, which is called yenech tovi matov, which means in a female form, your wine is the best. Actually, I will try to figure out how to translate it better.